Dinner is over. All the food has been eaten and leftovers are in the fridge. But what about those items that can't be eaten, like bones and corn cobs? They go in the green cart.
What about this used paper napkin?
That goes in too. And it's not just food scraps that can go into your green cart. Grass clippings, small tree branches, pet waste, cat litter, and food-soiled paper like napkins, tissues, and paper towels are all suitable for composting. In fact, the introduction of the green cart has meant an almost 50% reduction in the amount of residential material ending up in the landfill. Instead of sending food and yard waste to the landfill where it doesn't break down into anything useful, we are making it into a valuable resource.
And all we need is a plastic bag?
Actually, you don't use a plastic bag. Put items directly in your green cart or place them in compostable bags. Look for these logos on the box. Putting the wrong things like plastic in the cart creates contamination, which means more time and effort to produce quality compost.
Now, where does it all go?
The contents of your green cart end up at Calgary's composting facility. Let's take a look inside. Here it goes through a series of specialized systems, from the tipping floor and composting to screening and storage. The end result is nutrient-rich compost. Let's take a closer look at the whole process. It all starts at the tipping floor, where an average of 400 truckloads a week of material will be unloaded. On the tipping floor, large pieces of contamination are removed, and material is shredded into smaller pieces that will compost faster. Once it's shredded, front-end loaders and conveyors deposit it into one of 18 huge vessels. Each vessel is 7 meters high, 10 meters wide, and 54 meters long, and filled to about two-thirds capacity so there is enough space to circulate air and maintain high temperature.
Does everything at the facility come from green carts?
Well, not all of it. Biosolids, which are nutrient-rich resources that enhance plant growth and improve soil, water, and nutrient retention, also come to the facility from wastewater treatment. Biosolids get mixed with wood chips to optimize compostability before they're taken to separate vessels. Biosolids follow the same process as the material from your green cart, but the two streams are kept entirely separate and end up as two distinct kinds of compost.
What happens in the next step? Inside the vessels.
Once in the vessels, the materials naturally warm up and decomposers get to work. Decomposers are things like bacteria and fungi, which thrive in warm temperatures and also need oxygen and moisture to do the work of composting. The entire work in the vessel takes 21 days and is closely monitored for temperature, oxygen, and moisture. Outside air is pumped up through the floor and moisture is added from above so the decomposers can break it down. Water is recycled from all areas of the facility to keep the compost moist and minimize fresh water use. Reaching a temperature of 55 degrees Celsius ensures that harmful bacteria are eliminated. Composting sounds complicated, but it really is nature at work. We create and maintain optimal conditions to allow the composting process to happen naturally. It's similar to what happens in a backyard composter, but our process can handle even more items and a lot quicker too.
How do they remove things that aren't compostable?
When the active stage of the process is done and the material is removed from the vessel, it goes through a screening process which removes most things that don't belong, like plastics, rocks, and metals.
Wow, the way they screen out all that stuff is pretty cool.
Materials that are still too big, like large pieces of wood, get sent back to step one to be mixed with fresh green cart or biosolids material.
What happens after all the screening is done?
Then, all the good stuff goes to the curing building for 3 weeks. The curing process allows the decomposers to finish their job and the compost can cool down so it's safe to use on plants. Now it's time to take the final product onto the storage building.
How do we know it's safe to use?
Before anything leaves the Calgary composting facility, samples are tested for nutrients, organic matter, pathogens, trace metals, and foreign matter like plastic and glass to ensure the highest standards of safety and quality. And it's not just quality compost we're responsible for. We also want to be good neighbors, and controlling odors is part of that. The facility has a large filter that draws air from the active composting and curing phases and cleans it before it's allowed out of the facility. That's it! In just 60 days, yesterday's food scraps become today's compost, ready to be put to good use in our community. When we put the right things in our green cart, we can ensure a high-quality product while keeping valuable food and yard waste out of the landfill. This amazing program is a real asset to Calgarians.
I see that! I had no idea what happened with the stuff in my green cart. It's great to know I can make a big difference just by using my cart correctly.
Absolutely. You're helping us reach our goal of keeping waste out of landfills and making a positive difference today and for our future.